So if you are using Spring, especially anything involving data, most probably you came across the transaction annotation. It's like magic. You just put it above a method and it automatically handles transaction for us. Or at least we think it does. Here's the twist. Sometimes transaction annotation just quietly doesn't work. No errors, no warning. It just doesn't do the job. So in this video, we will break down two common traps even experienced developers falls into. Let's quickly go over what transaction annotation actually do. When you call a method annotated with transaction annotation, Spring says, I will start a transaction for you. If everything goes well, I will commit these changes. Otherwise, I will roll back the entire transaction. Now here's the part a lot of people miss, and it's really so important. Spring wraps your entire bean with something called a proxy. Basically, a wrapper object that sits in front of your class and intercepts calls to your method. So when a call comes from outside your bean, it goes through the proxy. The proxy knows it's annotated with transaction annotation, so it opens a transaction and handles everything. But here's the catch. If you call a method from inside the same bean, it skips the proxy. No interception, no transaction, just a regular method call. Which brings us to self-invocation. So let's say we have a bank service, and we injected the account repository using constructor injection. Then we declared a public void transfer method with a string from account number, string to account number, and a big decimal representing the amount. Inside the method, to illustrate the self-invocation issue, we will delegate the call to a method called performTransfer, passing in the same parameters. Then let's generate the performTransfer method and annotate it with the transactional annotation. For the implementation, we will start by fetching the fromAccount by calling accountRepository.findByAccountNumber, passing in the account number, or else we throw an exception. We will do the same to the toAccount. Now we can simply call fromAccount.withdraw, passing in the amount. And for the method implementation, it simply deducts from the account balance. We will do the exact opposite to the toAccount by calling deposit method, and instead of deducting the amount, we will add it to the existing balance. Finally, even if dirty checking mechanism will automatically update our data, we will explicitly call accountRepository.save for both accounts. Our implementation looks good, but it will not run inside a transaction, because transfer method is calling performTransfer from within the same bean. So the Spring proxy doesn't even know it's happening, and the transactional annotation part gets completely skipped. So if something goes wrong after deducting from the first account and before crediting the second account, it will not be able to roll back since they are not inside a single transaction. To fix the issue, you can technically inject your class to itself. But honestly, that's more of a hack than a fix. And here's why it's not recommended. It's confusing to read, breaks the single responsibility principle, can cause weird behavior in complex bean setups, it makes testing more painful, and it encourages more bad patterns. A better solution would be moving the logic to a separated service, which is cleaner and plays nicely inside Spring. Now we can simply inject our newly created service using constructor injection and simply call transferService.transfer, and this time we are sure both operations are executing within the same transaction. Since we fixed the issue, let's move on to our second trap. This one is all about transaction propagation, which sounds so fancy, but it's really just what happens when a transactional method calls another transactional method. Let's take an example by injecting the audit service, which I already prepared. In this service, we have access to the audit log repository, which allow us to insert a new audit log each time we do a transfer. Now, even the audit method is annotated with transactional annotation. Here what actually will happen. By default, Spring uses propagation.required, which basically means if there's already a transaction going, it will join that transaction. Otherwise, it will create its own transaction. So in our case, when we call the audit method from inside the perform transfer, they will both run inside the same transaction. To test that, let's fire up our server and call our endpoint. As you can see in the logs, the audit method found already existing transaction and participated within that transaction. Here's the problem with this approach. Now, if the perform transfer failed for any reason, it will also roll back the audit log method, which is not what we expect. We want to retain our audit logs even when the parent transaction fails. For that, we will simply navigate to the audit log method and update our transactional annotation with the propagation attribute and set it to propagation.requiresNew. Let's quickly test it out by restarting the server and calling the same endpoint once more. Now we can clearly see it suspended the current transaction and opened a new transaction, which means if an exception occurred at the parent level, it will not be able to roll back the audit transaction, which is exactly what we want. Hopefully, this will help you avoid those two common mistakes in the future, and for a deeper dive and more detailed explanation, feel free to check my course on Udemy Spring Transactions in depth.